Hey guys, this is Justin, and must we talk about this? I think we must. I'd say special thanks to Clownfish TV for bringing me this to my attention, but they don't deserve my thanks. I'm gonna keep my thanks for this one because this is aggravating me to the nth degree. Powerpuff to be repiloted. Tom Swift remains in contention. Our Ladies of Brooklyn and Painkiller not going forward. Okay, that part doesn't matter. What matters is Powerpuff, according to Deadline. And it's going to be rewritten. The pirate's going to be rewritten. Why is it rewritten? I'll show you in a second. One of CW's highest profile pilots, Powerpuff, is not going to series. At least not yet. Ahead of the CW's fall 2020 schedule announcement tomorrow, the network has made decision on the bulk of its six 2021 pilots, handing series orders to Naomi and All-American Homecoming. Powerpuff, based on the original Cartoon Network animated series, will be reworked and repiloted off-cycle. The four leads, as well as the other cast and writers, producers, all remain on board the project from Warner Bros. TV, Berlanti Productions. Yeah. Yeah, let's move on. Let's talk about this here. Rewritten and executive produced by Diablo Cody and Heather Regner, who will do the rewrite. Powerpuff follows the trio that used to be America's pint-sized superheroes. Now they're delusion 20-somethings who represent having lost their childhood to crime fighting. Warner Bros. TV Group President Channing Dungley last week spoke about Powerpuff and the challenges adapting the classic pop culture IP has faced. We have got a trio of terrific actresses at the center of that. I'm not going to say that it hasn't been a challenge. Oh, it's been a challenge. It's been a challenge. Bringing a children's cartoon in live-action adulthood has been a really fine line to walk. Yeah, there's like, you take one step and the line breaks off and you fall to your death. But I think we've done a pretty good job, great job walking it. Oh, really? Well, let's take a look at the leaked script and see how well we've been walking the line, shall we? Are you ready? Are you absolutely ready for this? It's not my thing. Don't blame the player. Blame the game. Here we go. I'm going to use voices close to the original characters in this case. This is coming from Xavier's Online, which is not the original tweeter, because guess what? The original tweeter had to delete this. Oh, I wonder why. Oh, I wonder why. Oh, I wonder why. So here we go.
Blossom's fine. I saw on Insta that she has a boyfriend. I saw on her LinkedIn that she got promoted. And then I saw on Facebook...
Oh my god. God, do we have to mention every single social media outlet? Oh my god. They're stereotyping millennials right now. All we care about, especially girls, well maybe some of the girls, all we care about is social media. LOL. YOLO. Alright, anyways.
And then I saw on Facebook that she still talks to Grandpa despite their political differences.
Why are we bringing up politics? Why are we bringing up politics? Powerpuff Girls never ever brought up politics. And who is Grandpa? There is no Grandpa. There never was a Grandpa. So anyways, Buttercup, coming back here is probably triggering for her. Triggering. Oh my god. Bubbles.
Why? Because he's the one who killed Mojo? I mean, moveon.org.
Oh my god. Wait a minute. Is there really such a thing as moveon.org? This I gotta see, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my god. It's wrong. <laughs> Now, I already read the script ahead of time, but I haven't checked this over time. This is so This is my real reaction, folks. This is live. Recovery restarts beautiful actions to coast to coast. Oh my god, this is real. And there's petitions. Take action. Campaigns. About us. About us. About us. Move On is where millions mobilize for a better society. One where everyone can thrive. Whether it's supporting a candidate, passing legislation, or changing our culture. No. No. Blossom wants to change. She's an SJW. No. No. Oh my god. No. Did they know? Did they know? Oh. Okay. 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 Let's move on. This is a Buttercup now. Boss, wake up, or we'll leak your nudes everywhere. Oh. Oh, jeez. That worked once on you. Oh, man. Now they got nudes. Why? Why? Why are you doing this, CW? Why? Alright, and then the last one. This is... You gotta get ready for this. This is even worse. Bubbles.
Look, we love being Powerpuff Girls, but sometimes we want to do other things. Or sometimes we want to be other things. Like... In Dirty Dancing. Baby wants to join the Peace Corps, but he also wanted to be a fancy slut. And I didn't get it.
So now the Powerpuff Girls want to be, pole dancers. Oh, please, don't do it. Drake. I have no idea who Drake is, so I'm just going to use my, Ron Toivos.
Jerry Obrecht was doing his best to understand.
Okay, this is the worst part, ladies and gentlemen. This is the worst part. Powerpuff Girls home, hallway, Buttercup's room, day. Blossom heads upstairs where the bumping sound... No, this is not going to end well. This is not going to end well. Where the bumping sound continues from Buttercup's room, then abruptly stops. Blossom opens the door and finds Buttercup in bed with Macy. No. How about no? I'll show you why no. Because we've determined in the original series that Buttercup is not gay. Take a look at this episode of the original Powerpuffs. You can see that Buttercup, the episode's called Buttercrush. Why? Because she has a crush on this guy from the Gangrene Gang, the boss. I'm forgetting his name, but see, look at that. Buttercup has a crush on him. A guy.
Unless she's bi and we don't know about it, but I highly doubt it.
This is ridiculous. They're ruining my childhood right here. Anyways, let's continue. The woman she eyed... I just noticed that part. The woman she eyed at the bar the night before. The woman she eyed at the bar the night before. They just finished.
Oh God, I'm sorry. It's fine.
To Macy.
We're done, right?
Macy.
I'd say six times is enough.
This is gonna blow so hard. We have another article about Powerpuff from Deadline that I want to talk to you about. Powerpuff, the CW boss Mark Pedales expands on this decision rework. Repilot live action reboot. This was just a miss. Oh, really? It was a miss, all right. It was a swing and a miss. Strike one, strike two, strike three, you're out. You're out. You're out. You're out. While some new titles are set to premiere on the CW as part of its 2021-2022 fall slate, the anticipated Powerpuff live-action reboot did not make the cut and will be reworked and repiloted. The CW's Mark Pedell expanded on the decision, noting that holding the series back will provide an opportunity to do it right by it. Yeah, right. They're not going to do right by it. Here's how you do right by it. Put it in the trash. The reason we do pilots is sometimes things miss. This was just a miss. We believe in the cast completely. We believe in Diablo and Heather, the writers, in this case. The pilot didn't work. Then why do you believe them? Why do you believe them? Ugh. Look, guys, I don't know if I can handle this. I don't think this is going to be any better. The only way this is going to be any better is if Powerpuff gets canceled. Fortunately, because it's a live-action remake, they're able to see this stuff. Whereas with animation, you can make something horrible, but they won't know until it's too late. Because animation takes months and months in advance to make. I remember Mark Evanier saying there was this one cartoon, and they were screening it with someone from one of the three networks. And she was horrified at how horrible this cartoon was, and there was nothing they could do about it. And she was pacing around. It was going to air the next day, actually. They were seeing this on a Friday night. It airs on a Saturday morning, and there's nothing you can do about it. And she's like, can you give me the producer's number? And Mark was like, no, I don't know it, which is a lie, obviously. But anyways, that's kind of the only good thing about it being live action. Now, the other live-action remake we're still keeping an eye out is The Loud House. It's for, it's this Christmas movie remake. And I'm seeing snapshots out of it, and so far, so good. I'd like to see what the Loud Sisters look like, and if Ronnie Ann is in it, what she looks like. But other than that, it looks pretty good. As far as the Rugrats reboot, perfect. We don't need to talk about that. I mean, we could talk about it, but I don't feel the need to do the YouTube video. Just go watch the some videos on it. You'll see what I mean. You're going to like it when it comes out. This, however, we're done. We're done. We're done. We're done. I'm done with this video. I'm done with this. Goodbye.